are going to start our new topic. According to this topic, in the previous classes, we have started our lesson 2, in which we have completed the digestive system. Few practice material, practice questions I have given to you for solving that at your home. And I hope you have all tried all those questions. And second part is there. After the first system, which we have completed, digestive system, we have started our second system. And that second system, which we have started yesterday, that is respiratory system. And in the respiratory system, yesterday I have told you about the respiration. So let me take a quick revision of the things. The first thing is there, respiration, which we have studied yesterday. And what is respiration? Respiration is actually catabolic process in which oxygen taken from the atmosphere is used to oxidize the food inside our body and release energy from that. That process is called what? Respiration. So about the respiration, how it is happening, how it is takes place, all that introduction I have given in the previous class. Now today I am going to tell you about the types of the respiration. So in respiration, whatever I have told you, after that I am going to start types of respiration. So there are two types of respiration. Two types of respiration. Number one, which is considered, that is external respiration. External respiration. Second one, internal respiration. So let us start the first type of the respiration that we are calling external respiration. In external respiration, what happens actually? Air coming from where? From our surrounding atmosphere, right? And that air is reaching where? Reaching into the lungs of the person. So one system is this, that a process in which we are taking air into the lung from our atmosphere. The first process is what? The air entering into our lung from atmosphere or from surrounding. That process is called external respiration. Because respiration means what? Breathing only, right? So let me tell you about the definition of this. It is a process in which air is entering into our lung from atmosphere. From atmosphere by breathing. That is called external respiration. External respiration. Clear? So external respiration means what? It is a process in which air is entering into our lungs from atmosphere by breathing. Breathing is the process by which we are taking the air inside our body. That is called external respiration. The second one is there, internal respiration. What is internal respiration? Lung. Suppose this is the lung. In this lung, air is present. Now, from here, so many blood capillaries are present. In alveoli part, so many blood capillaries are present in which blood is flowing. So, this air is diffused inside this blood and reaching to the cells and tissues. So, that kind of process, that kind of respiration is called internal respiration. Right? So, it is a process in which air is entering into our blood and from the blood it is reaching to our cells and tissues from the lungs by breathing process. Right? That is called internal respiration. So, it is a process in which air is entering into our blood and then reaching to the cells and tissues. From lungs by breathing process. That is called internal respiration. Internal respiration. Right? I hope you are getting both the kinds. The first one is there, external respiration. The second one is there, that is called internal respiration. So, the main important one is about which we are going to learn and in which respiratory system working inside our body, that is internal respiration, that we are going to cover. So, after then, I will tell you all the parts of the respiratory system which are working in our internal respiration. Right? So, the main important organ for the respiration, once again I am telling you, that is what? Lung. Now, let me tell you one more thing. External respiration, internal respiration. But internal respiration is again divided into the two parts. Now, internal respiration are of two types. Number one, aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration. Second one is anaerobic respiration. Right? So, the first one is the aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration is what actually? It is a process in which breathing is done in the presence of air. Means in the presence of oxygen, in the presence of air, if we are doing respiration, that respiration is called aerobic respiration. If in the absence of air we are doing the respiration, that is called anaerobic respiration. For example, when you are running so fast, during that time your body is not able to take the air continuously inside your body, right? So what is happening? Lacking of air inside your body, then also respiration process is going on. Means your food is broken and energy is released. That kind of respiration is called anaerobic respiration. So let me tell you first, aerobic respiration. It is a respiration which takes place. It is a respiration which takes place in the presence of air, or you can say oxygen. That is called aerobic respiration. Second one is there, anaerobic respiration. It is a respiration which takes place in the present, which takes place in the absence of air and oxygen. That is called anaerobic respiration. Right? Now, see here what is happening. Let me give you one example also. Benefit and harm also regarding this. In your body, if aerobic respiration takes place, then the product which is released, that is always glucose from the aerobic respiration. After breaking of food, after releasing of energy, the product, releasing product from the chemical reaction that is coming out, that is for glucose, and the formula is C6H12O6. Right? And the second one, from the anaerobic respiration, the releasing product which is coming out after breaking of the food, hormone. Define external respiration. Define internal respiration. Question number 3. Define aerobic and anaerobic respiration. So, thank you very much, class. Try to find out the answer of them. Thank you. Thank you very much.